Do you look up in awe at the sheer cliff faces of glass and steel making up the canyons of our modern-day cities and think, I could do that? Are you unafraid of heights, no matter how high? Do you take pride in your work? Are you detail-oriented and serious-minded about your work? Are you a team player, dependable, reliable, punctual, and consistent? Does the prospect of working with detailed measurements and exacting procedures challenge you?
If it does, you might be the kind of person to consider an apprenticeship as a glazer in the IUPAT. So exactly what does a glazer do? An architectural glass and metal technician is called a glazer. A glazer is responsible for selecting, cutting, installing, replacing, and removing
all types of glass, engineered materials used in creating the envelope of a building. The creative use of large windows, glass doors, skylights, and sunroom additions make buildings bright, airy, and inviting. Additionally, you could be glazing interior work, creating storefronts, installing decorative handrails, and even installing high-end shower doors. But it doesn't stop there.
As a glazer, you would be responsible for
work on the glass exteriors of large commercial buildings, replacing storefront windows for establishments such as supermarkets, auto dealerships, or banks. You'll be cutting, grinding, polishing, and using sealants, of course. The handling of sheets of glass in the warehouse and during transportation and installation using slings and power lift devices like scissor lifts and forklifts. Promoting the application of green technology, solar technology, and sustainability through the design and installation of energy-efficient weatherization materials and solar technology in both residential and commercial applications. Working with pre-cut and mounted glass and frames at a factory or a contractor shop. Preparing work either inside or outside a building, and use scaffolding and elevated lifts for installations. Perform administrative tasks such as preparing estimates and invoices, tracking a job, and estimating manpower.
As you can see from this long list, glazers perform hundreds of tasks related to glass and many other materials.
The kind of knowledge required to perform this job well is as varied as the tools and techniques you will learn to use.
You'll need to know the federal, state, and provincial regulations that govern your trade, and undergoing training will keep you and others safe on the job.
You'll need to learn project management if you hope to move up to foreman, superintendent, or project manager. You may be dealing with clients on the job, and it always helps to be good at it. Communication is key, and it will be both written and verbal. The more you know, the faster you can progress in your expertise.
As we've just seen, glazers work in a variety of settings and with countless tools, techniques, and materials. Because of this, sometimes there are dangerous facets of the job that glazers must be aware of. Some of the concerns for glazers include working at height, including work on ladders and scaffolds, meaning potential fall injuries. Handling large, awkward, heavy sheets of glass and engineered metal could lead to back and arm injuries. Working in awkward positions and standing for long periods of time. Again, back and arm injuries, slips, trips, and falls. Cuts and lacerations from sharp edges of glass. Eye injuries from dust and flying particles when cutting, grinding, and polishing of glass. Exposures to solvents and adhesives, sealants, and cleaning products. Working outdoors in hot or cold weather and working alone.
Some specialized tools, materials, and techniques you'll need to master are architectural drawings, specifications, and contract documents that describe the work to be done, the methods of construction, and the standards of workmanship. This is critical. Accuracy in layout, which can be attained through the use of levels and transit-type instruments. Skills in using the parts of a transit or level. Setting up an instrument on any type of surface, and the basics of reading those instruments. You'll need to understand the effects of temperature and other outside elements, storage, and handling techniques.
The installation of special types of glass like hurricane-resistant, bullet, or blast-resistant glass, and other security applications.
A familiarity with architectural metals and other materials, such as aluminum used in fabrication. You aren't limited to glass. Knowledge of plastics, their types, purpose, and use in today's glazing applications is also key. You'll need to know how to safely connect and disconnect a photovoltaic system, the components, materials used in the installation, and how to make a complete photovoltaic system.
Like many trades, you'll need to master the fundamentals of shielded metal arc welding, including safety considerations and precautions. You'll need to be aware of electrical hazards, as you will be working with power tools, higher voltages for lifts and equipment. Finally, all architectural glass and metal technicians need to use and handle swing stage equipment safely and use fall arresting equipment to prevent serious or fatal injuries. So, as you can see, there is a lot more to being an architectural glass and metal technician than just no fear of heights. The basic skills needed to be a good glazer are the same as those that make up a professional tradesperson. You'll need to be able to be effective at listening to others, not interrupting, and asking the right questions, thinking about the pros and cons of different ways to solve a problem. A basic knowledge of mathematical functions is crucial to the glazer, who will need to apply that knowledge and use mathematical skills and applications specific to the glazing trade. Of course, the bulk of your job is going to be the handling of tools and materials, and to be an excellent glazer, you will have to master them. Let's look at the physical abilities you'll need to make a good glazer. If you have issues with your hand strength or working with hand tools, this may not be the job for you. You must have balance, endurance, and be in good physical condition. You must have no chest complaints. This is physically demanding work. This cannot be stressed enough. If there ever was a trade that required the hands of a surgeon, it's a glazier. You will need to measure accurately and make precise visual judgments. The ability to solve arithmetic problems quickly and accurately is necessary to be precise and accurate in the use of your tools and materials at every step of the way. You'll learn a number of tools and use a number of techniques in this trade, many of which are quite physical and almost all require a great attention to detail. If you don't have these physical abilities, then you might want to consider a less demanding trade. You might ask yourself, what does personality have to do with being a glazer? Like all the trades, you are part of a team, so teamwork is essential. Interpret written and verbal instructions well and recognize the importance of cooperation and interaction with related occupations on a job site, dealing with different customers in a professional and courteous manner. You'll need to exhibit suitable appearance and personal hygiene. Using computers is a fact of life in any job these days. The trades are no exception. You must be willing to learn new technology and techniques. It takes more than just a keen eye and steady hand. It takes maturity and professionalism too. It all boils down to being able to work well with others, communicate clearly, and be dependable. You might ask yourself, what kind of education do I need to be a glazer? Your credentials will be nationally recognized in the industry and can open the door for you to get a job with a good company anywhere in the country. And the IUPAT can also assist you in furthering your education. Now, as you continue in your career after completing your apprenticeship and becoming a journey worker, you'll want to pursue additional training and certifications, and this will require more classroom time and on-the-job training. Employment in the glazing trade is less seasonal than in most of the construction occupations. Many buildings are moving to new energy-efficient glass technologies, and there will be an opportunity in this renovation business for years to come. Employment growth is expected as commercial construction increasingly uses glass exteriors for buildings. So, just to recap, a glazer is exposed to the elements, dangers from falls, cuts from broken glass, and a full day of exacting physical labor. If you aren't motivated, disciplined, and dedicated to improving skills and knowledge of the glazing trade, this trade is not for you. If you aren't 100% confident in your mental and physical ability to work in such a fast-paced, detail-oriented, and ever-changing environment, or your ability to be aware of the hazards associated with glasswork, then you might want to reconsider your interest in being a glazer. It's not for everyone. Are you right for this trade? Is this trade right for you? This is an important question, and one you should consider carefully. Explore your bold future today by considering a career in the IUPAT.